I am Lieutenant Governor Dan Forrest, and I'm here today with my good friend, Representative Craig Horn from Union County. And I want to dive right in and talk a little bit about what it was like growing up. Where did you grow up? What was kind of the background going on in the country at the time? And what were some of the things that you did as a kid? And how has the world changed since you were a kid?
I was born before D-Day. I lived in a lot of different homes. Once counted 13 different homes and I think 9 different schools. Much of my young life was spent on an island in the Mississippi River, a virtual Tom Sawyer story with lots of snakes and rabbits and frogs, and go fishing every day and play in the woods. Later, we finally moved into town. I actually moved into a house with indoor toilet. I remember thinking that there was something a little sick about people who went to the bathroom in the house. That just didn't sound right to me.
Being a Churchill guy and a scholar on Churchill, and you spent many years studying Churchill and speaking on behalf of the Churchill Society around the country and around the world. Mm-hmm. The Dardanelles were a specific point in history for Churchill. Talk just a little bit about what the Dardanelles meant to Churchill back in the early 1900s.
In World War I, trench warfare was going nowhere. It was brutal, cruel, terrible. And there was a stalemate on the European front. Churchill agreed with a plan that was brought to him to do an end run, a flanking movement on the Axis or then the Reich, and to move up through the Dardanelles, cutting off the German advance into the oil fields of the Middle East. Churchill felt, as did many others, that if they could breach the Dardanelles leading up into Constantinople, that they would be able to contain and then, if you will, backdoor the Germans. The problem is that although Churchill was blamed for the failure of the Dardanelles campaign, problem is that many of the people in the military just did not buy into his thoughts. So they were very slow in the uptake.
And given more time, we could probably talk about this all day. I'm going to change the subject on you a little bit, but just let the viewers know if there's any interest to continue to look at Winston Churchill. The seminal work on Winston Churchill is The Last Lie in the 3-volume series that will take quite some time to read, but well worth it in the end. I'm going to change the subject to education.
Sure.
Obviously, you're very involved in education, leading appropriations in the House of Representatives here in North Carolina. Talk a little bit about your vision for education, what you want to see, the transition you want to see. We've talked about digital textbooks, and we passed a bill about digital textbooks, rather. Talk about that. Talk about where education's going in North Carolina.
I believe we are, here in North Carolina, we are perfectly positioned to lead the nation and, in fact, the world in a fundamental change in how we will deliver education, not just in North Carolina, but across the country and around the world. With the digital education environment, we can deliver the finest education in the world to the most poor and most rural person in our state. We are particularly well positioned, as I mentioned, because of our connectivity already. Although we still have a ways to go, we are well ahead of pretty much everyone else in connecting our schools. We need to, though, ensure that connectivity goes beyond the schoolhouse into the schoolroom and into the home, because education doesn't stop at the schoolhouse door, nor does it stop at 5 o'clock or 3 o'clock whenever school lets out. So I'm convinced that we are well on our way to a fundamental change in how we deliver education, both using the digital environment as well as how we construct schools and classrooms, how we schedule the school day or the school week, how students take tests, how students learn, how teachers teach. We are truly at the front door of a brave new world in education, and I think that North Carolina will lead the charge internationally.
Thank you for your service to the state. Hope there'll be many more years of doing this, and your reputation precedes you around the state as well. So we appreciate what you're doing. We appreciate you taking time to talk with us a little bit today, and we'll look forward to the next time.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.